Welcome, welcome, welcome to Redeemer Kids Online. We're so excited that you're here. My name is Shalisha.
And my name is Sir Monty Lewis Greenberg the 17th. But you can call me Monty for short. I'm actually from New York, but I live here now, and my favorite color is orange.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I think I'm just going to move on. Today is the fifth week of our Thankful series.
It's been 5 weeks! Time really does fly when you're learning about the most incredible person in the whole world, Jesus! Wait, I think I forgot to take a shower.
Oh, did you not have time this morning because you slept in?
No, I forgot to shower this whole month.
You what?
Yeah, I know.
So that's what I was smelling.
So, yeah, why don't we just move on?
All right, let's sing this out together.
When night has fallen and fear is calling, still you're calling me. When faith is lost and my hope exhausted,
RKids to another RKids game time.
My name's Bree.
My name's Sam.
And we are so excited to be here with you today.
Yes, we are.
You may be wondering, what do all these things on this table have in common? The answer is, not a thing.
Dang. But you know what we all have in common? We just celebrated Thanksgiving.
Woo! So good. Come Such on. A good day.
So, what is the purpose of all these items, Bree?
Well, we are going to have to do some simple daily tasks, but there's one catch.
What is it?
We will not be allowed to use our thumbs. This is called the No Thumbs Challenge.
Do I like pull my thumb off or?
No, we're just gonna. We're just gonna leave it like this and okay. Trust that we're not gonna use it. All okay. Right? We're just gonna go by the honor system here.
I trust you.
Yeah, I trust you too, so we got this. So, what we're gonna do is first we're gonna just open a jar of peanut butter. Super simple. After that, we're gonna move on to our shoe. We're gonna tie our shoe, and then we will move on to the flannel. The flannel we are going to unbutton, we're gonna put it on, and then button it up. Whoever finishes first is the winner.
Come on.
Alrighty, but no thumbs. That's the only rule.
No thumbs.
No thumbs. Alrighty. All right, you ready?
Let's go for
it. Here we go. Starting with the peanut butter.
Three, two, one. Let's get it.
Go.
Hey! Come on, Team Sam. Wait, are we doing bunny ears?
That's the only way.
Yes!
No way.
Wait, this one's hard.
Eep. Okay. Sam, you're making me nervous.
It's okay, Bree. All's fair.
I'm like,
we got it. Who are y'all rooting for?
Me?
Come on, Team Sam. Wait, these buttons are hard.
I'm over here like, which one's my thumb? Which one can I use?
Our thumbs are up.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, great. Well, keep your thumb up.
Oh, I almost used it.
Oh!
Sorry, did
that
mean I used my thumb?
I think it did, but it's okay. We all make mistakes.
Sam!
Oosh.
Do you not use your thumbs?
No.
That's weird.
Wait, it's not coming on.
Come on.
Freedom!
Oh my goodness!
This is gonna be hard, y'all.
Oop. Hopefully that part was good.
Oop. Oop.
Oh my gosh. Thank God for thumbs, man. This is tragic.
Did you know? I think just humans and monkeys are the only people the only animals with thumbs. Like, other animals don't have thumbs, like, to grip stuff with. It's all paws. Have you ever seen a dog walk or, like, cats, they only have their paws? Yeah, we're a very special breed. Come on.
Oh, this is bad.
Wait, are we doing top button? Like, collar?
No.
Okay.
I don't know.
Oh, you got it.
I'm trying. My fingers are weak.
Here, grip it. Put the button in between two.
You're helping?
Open the hole. Of course,
competitor.
You're my friend.
This is so kind.
Open the hole and then push it through.
Oh.
Push it through. Yeah, with that finger. Keep going. With your left hand, push through. And then grab it with your right. You got it. You got it! You're so close! Ready? Look!
Oh my gosh!
Push it through. Make sure the hole's wide enough.
Mine are different than yours. Uh-huh. Okay. Alright.
Yes.
Just go, man. Just go.
Yes. Eat. Ooh, one left! It gets harder when you go further.
My fingers aren't working.
Okay. And then three. Wait, no. No, did it. Yes. We had so much fun with y'all, today, RKids. Bree, how much fun did you have?
So much fun. My fingers failed me a little bit, but it was fun. It was fun. You can try this at home as well.
We had so much fun doing this with y'all for the month of November.
Yes. I hope you guys had a great month of thankfulness, and we will see you guys hopefully next time.
Bye.
Hey,
I'm Katie. Are you ready for our challenge? We have been learning our Bible verse for 4 weeks now, so hopefully you've memorized it. So I want to challenge you to say it with your eyes closed. Are you ready? Let's go. Philippians 2:21, for to me to live is Christ and to die is gain. Awesome job, guys. We'll see you next week for a new memory verse.
When Paul was a prisoner in Rome, people brought him news about how believers in churches all over the world were doing. Paul had visited many of these churches, and he wrote letters to encourage the Christians in each church.
Paul wrote a letter to the church in Colossae. The Colossian believers knew the gospel, but false teachers had been telling them lies. This confused them. Some were saying there was a secret gospel only they knew about. Paul wrote to remind them the truth about Jesus. This is what Paul wrote.
Jesus shows us what God is like. The Son of God existed before God created anything. He created everything. Everything in heaven and on earth. Everything you see and don't see. Everything exists for Him. Jesus holds everything together. The church, all the believers in the world, are the body, and He is the head. God was happy to send His Son to earth to rescue people from sin through His blood on the cross.
Paul reminded the believers that their sin had separated them from God. They were His enemies. But now they had salvation and forgiveness through Jesus.
Paul had told them the complete gospel. Anyone who came and said there was a secret gospel was lying. Be encouraged and love one another, Paul wrote. I want you to know Jesus. All wisdom and knowledge is found in Him.
Paul encouraged believers by reminding them that Jesus is great. Jesus is God's Son, and He died on the cross to rescue people from sin. The gospel is true, and Jesus is all we need.
Hey guys, Miss Donna here, and today we're talking about the true gospel. Do you remember in the video how the people in Colossae, even though they were believers and knew the gospel, were listening to false teachers who were telling them lies and confusing them? Paul was troubled. Here he was in prison and heard that the believers were being deceived by false teachings. So he wrote a letter reminding them of the truth about Jesus. That same message that Paul told the Colossians is the same message for all of us today. Let's review what the Bible says about Jesus. The Bible tells us that Jesus is the image of the invisible God. If you want to know what God is like, look at Jesus. He reflects God's character. The Bible also tells us that Jesus existed before anything else was created, and He created everything. He is in charge of everything, even invisible things. He holds everything together. The church and all of the believers in the world can take comfort in Him, even when life is hard, because He loves us and takes care of us, and He is in control. Paul reminded the believers that their sin had separated them from God, but Jesus died on the cross to rescue them from sin. Through Jesus and only Jesus, they now have salvation and forgiveness. Jesus is the only way. If anyone tells you otherwise, they are not speaking the truth. This week's lesson on deception and false teaching kind of reminds me of this. Now, how many of you think you can tell me what this is? I'm sure we've all seen it around, huh? The truth is, no one really knows what it is. It could be meat. It could be a bunch of things made to taste like meat that isn't really meat at all. Those kinds of foods go by many names like chuck wagon or beef patty or potted meat. But for years, the universally accepted term for this kind of food was mystery meat. Now, we may never know what mystery meat is, but we can almost surely know what it's not. It's not chicken, it's not pork, it's not beef. How do we know that? Because we know what chicken, pork, and beef look like, and we know what they smell like, and we know what they taste like. When you smell a burger on the grill or fresh fried chicken, you don't need somebody to tell you what you're about to eat. You know. Your mouth starts to water and your stomach growls. When you smell mystery meat, your stomach might make noises too, but ooh, maybe not good noises. Mystery meat is not the real thing. Just like there are foods that look like the real thing, there are people teaching false gospels that sound like the real thing. Since the days of the early church, there have been people who take the words of Christ and twist them for their own selfish reasons. They can be very convincing and sound right, but how do you know what they're teaching is the real thing or not? You know mystery meat when you see it because you've eaten enough real meat to know what it's supposed to taste like. In the same way, you can get to know Jesus by spending time with him. Make prayer a daily part of your life and listen when you pray. Another way that you can get to know the true gospel is to read the gospel. Read the Bible daily and with other believers. Memorizing scripture will help you remember the teachings of Jesus. The more time you spend with Jesus, the better you will know his word, and you'll be able to smell a false gospel a mile away. Ugh. If you haven't started your relationship with God, you can start it right now. All you have to do is ask God to forgive you of your sins, believe in your heart that Jesus died on the cross for you and rose again, and confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and you are saved. It's so easy for us to join God's family because he made it this way for us. So I want you to repeat this prayer after me and really mean it from your heart. Dear Jesus, I know that I'm a sinner and have made bad choices. I'm sorry for all of my sins. Jesus, I believe in you. I believe that you died on the cross for my sins. And I believe that you're alive today. Please forgive me of my sins and come into my life today. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Guys, that's awesome. That's the most important decision that you will ever make, and I'm so excited for you. Make sure you tell a parent or a trusted adult about your decision and have them text the word KID, K-I-D, to 313131. We have a very special gift that we want to send to you.
We're back. It's so good to know that the more time we spend reading God's word, the easier it is to know what's right from what's not right. I hope that each of you take time each day to read your Bible and talk to God so you can learn how to make the right choices.
I know, I'm gonna make sure I do that.
Mm-hmm.
You have a lot of energy right now, Monty.
Well, today is an exciting day.
Is it your birthday?
No, it's not my birthday.
A holiday?
Nah.
Well, what makes today so exciting?
Well, today was the fifth and final weekend of our thankful series.
That seems a little sad to me.
Well, yeah, I guess so. But I think you're forgetting that it means we get to start a whole new series next week.
Oh, that's right.
And it's gonna be all about Jesus' birth. We'll have all new games. Oh, and a new memory verse. And it's gonna be all winter themed. Whew.
Yikes, Monty. All your excitement is getting me excited. Well, you all heard it. Be here next week for the start of our new series. We'll see you there.
Bye. Bye.
Hey RKids Online, we are starting a new series on the first weekend of December, which means we are handing out new Sunday Fun Day bags this Wednesday. It will have activity pages, candy, and maybe a couple more surprise items. Stop by our Gaithersburg, Frederick, or Clarksburg campus to pick yours up.